Graph the function f of x equals negative 1.5x squared. Now since we have a quadratic equation, it's going to be a parabola. There's no x term and no constant term, so the vertex has to be at 0, 0. Then we're going to use this first term, or only term, negative 1.5x squared, to find the other points we need to plot to draw the parabola. So we'll start with an input of 1, so negative 1.5 times 1 squared is just negative 1.5 times 1, or negative 1.5. That means we'll go right 1 and then down 1.5. And we're going down because we have a negative 1.5. Next point, negative 1.5 times 2 squared, that is negative 1.5 times 4, which is negative 6. So that means I'm going to right from the vertex and then down 6. 2, 4, 6. That's the next point on the parabola. Now let's take a look at the next value. Negative 1.5 times 3 squared, that's negative 1.5 times 9, and that is negative 13.5. Let's see if that even fits on the graph. So I'm going to go right 3 and then down 13.5. 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Well, 13.5 would be about down here somewhere. This is a target for drawing your parabola to make sure it's a little more accurate, but this is an optional point as far as I'm concerned because it doesn't really fit on the grid. It's up to you. So now I'm going to use symmetry through the vertex and reflect these points that I plotted onto the other side. And this one is a particular challenge because it's not on the grid. See, maybe about right there. And then you should get a really good idea of the U shape that you're going to draw here. So let me go ahead and draw that. This time I'm going to start at the vertex and draw it down. Okay, so there's half. And there's the other half. Let's review the steps one more time. Plot the vertex point first. Then you use this negative 1.5x squared to find the distance vertically that you go for each additional move to the right of the vertex. Then you reflect those points and draw your parabola.